Hello. What I'm going to show you today is how to make a buckling analysis on robot structural analysis professional. So let's start by picking the project. We'll work on a 3D frame design project. Let's close this and this, and now draw some axes to help us define our structure. Y-axis, how it should be divided, Z-axis, and apply. Click close, select this little house here, and we can see our axis by now. So let's start by defining our columns. We will pick a steel profile, which will be a HEB, which will be this one, I guess. It's good. Let's just push this here over to the right. Now, let's define the beams, which will be an EPE 300, I guess it's good. Click and drag so that we drag from this position to this one, this one, this one, and this one. Click close. Here we have our simple three-dimensional structure. So what about changing the display now? I want to see the section shape, a legend by color, and I don't want to see the structural axis anymore. Here we have. Now let's define a cladding to help me transferring the loads. Pick geometry, claddings, load distribution two-way. Pick this node, this node, this node, this node, and this node to close it. Now we have a cladding. Select the little house once again. Close the view. Define the supports. I'm going to pick pinned supports. Apply. Select the load case. That load case 1 will be the self-weight. Now let's find the buckling case load and add. Close this. Load definition for the buckling case. Surface load, uniform planar load, negative 10 kilopascal. Add and apply to the cladding. Apply. We can see the load here applied. Let's ask the program to make a buckling analysis out of the buckling case. Analysis types, buckling case, change the analysis type, buckling analysis, OK. As this is just an example, I'm going to pick 10 number of modes, OK. You can run the calculations here, or run the calculations here. As you may see, robot tells me that the analysis type is a linear buckling analysis type, as I wanted. Select the calculations button. Now, let's check the results. For checking the results, we may turn off the section shape and the cladding. Buckling case, which is our load case, and the type of displacements that I want to see is this one, results types, modes. I want to see the buckling modes. Select this one here, results, diagrams for bars, push this over to the left, deformation, pick the deformation, normalize, and we may see, I guess, may see here the first mode. The second mode, the third mode, the fourth, fifth, mode number 6, mode number 7, 8, 9, and 10. Now, one important aspect is the coefficient of each mode, the critical coefficient of the load for each of the modes. You may check that value over here. Just select results, advanced, critical loads, and you may check the critical coefficient over here. Thank you very much.